This is Harai, our 42-foot Vauquier Centurion, built in 1987. We bought the boat 3 years ago in Holland, and now after a refit and delays due to COVID, we're setting sail heading into the Arctic. We are making our way up the west coast of Scotland, leaving from Ardrossan, crossing the North Sea to Norway, then heading up the Norwegian coast to hopefully cross the Barents Sea to Svalbard.
First stop after rounding the Mull of Kintyre will be a brief stay at the Isle of Gier, while we wait for the tide to be able to take us up to Oban. Then up through the Sound of Mull and an overnight sail to Stornoway, at the top of the Outer Hebrides.
We set off with good wind and clear skies. This gave us some great conditions to further tweak our new sails and test our newly installed hydrovane self-steering system. Surprisingly, this was easier to get to grips with than we thought it would be.
Miserable wet night at Gier. The next morning the weather cleared up again and we caught the northerly going tide, which gave us some nice downwind sailing through to Oban.
We managed to catch up with a few friends for the night on the Isle of Carrera. This is on the opposite side of the bay to Oban. On to Stornoway in a bit of a breeze. As we made our way through the Sound of Mull, this built up to a forecasted steady force 7. Though sailing upwind made it a little lumpy, we were keen to give the new sails a good shakedown before going further. And with the stay sail out and a couple of reefs in the main, the boat cracked on nicely. Surprisingly, we weren't the only ones out.
Later in the day, the wind dropped to a steady 15 knots, and we sailed through the night to bring the boat into Stornoway the following morning. We were at Stornoway waiting for a good weather window to be able to continue on the next leg. So while keeping an eye on the forecast, we enjoyed the unseasonably warm weather. We also provisioned the boat with a few more final supplies, as we knew Norway was going to be really expensive.
Was looking good, and it seemed we might be able to sail the whole 480 miles to Norway in one go. From leaving Stornoway, our planned route would pass close to the top of the Shetland Islands, so we always had the option to stop at the Isle of Unst on the way. There were two weather systems coming through back to back, and if these merged as predicted, we would be able to make it all the way to Ålesund.
Rather than bob around in the North Sea with no wind, or after motor, we pulled into Ålesund on the Isle of Unst. As the wind filled back in the following day, we carried on and made some good speed, covering the remaining 250 nautical miles in a little over 36 hours.
North of the Magnus oil fields offshore platforms. It's 2:30 a.m. and dawn's already rising.
As we cross into Norwegian waters, we raise the courtesy flag and catch our first sight of Norway. Sheltered us from the wind and the sails came down. As we motored the last few miles in, we were treated to a glorious sunrise and our first good look at the magnificent Norwegian coastline.
In this episode, we explore Norway's fjords and coastal islands and officially cross over into the Arctic Circle.